sand or something. And this is the Corsair K70 RGB Mark II low profile rapid fire mechanical gaming keyboard, and that is quite a mouthful. And I went for this low profile keys because I am used to a laptop keyboard and I prefer the shorter throw switch. And hopefully that's what this is going to give me. And the lighting on this actually enables you to individually light each key in whatever color you want, so I'm looking forward to that. Let's have a look at the back of the box, shall we? And there we go. And here we have the information about the switches here. And the normal average, as they describe it here, switch actuator is 2 millimeters, whereas with this switch, the MX low profile speed switch, only 1 millimeter. Now that is a very small amount of difference, but it's 50% of the normal. So although you might think, well, I'm not sure I'd be able to tell the difference between a 2 millimeter throw and a 1 millimeter throw, I think in direct comparison, you would definitely notice. And here we have a lot of information about the keyboard. And these are Cherry switches. The keyboard itself is made of aluminium. And it has a quite incredible 8 megabytes of onboard lighting and macro profile storage. So you can keep your own profiles on there and lighting setups, and actually stored locally on the keyboard rather than having to send them via the computer. And dynamic multicolor per key backlighting, as I was saying. Hopefully each of these keys will be able to be individually illuminated a different color. And it also has a USB pass through, which is going to be super handy. Let's open it up and see what it looks inside. Now there are two plastic tabs here. So once again, I'm going to cut those. Let's see what we have inside. Let's turn it this way up. There we go, I can see now. That's quite satisfying. Itself. It's in this very nice plastic. Let's open up these little cardboard parts here, which I think will be holding together the cable. Yes, here we go. And that is a very substantial cable. Look at that. That is braided. Very thick gauge cable, a really nice USB on either end. That is lovely. Okay, let's open this up here. And just temporarily put it to one side. And here we have the inside of the box, and we can see this phrase here. Play through whatever. Which is a strange phrase, play through. Whatever. I don't know what they're getting at with that, but it's written in a quite a 90s style, actually, I think, to my eye. Let's have a look at what's here. Inside that little bag, we have a little instruction booklet and warranty information, which I shall put to one side, as most of us probably do. And this is, it's a reasonably thick booklet, but the English part is only the first couple of pages, literally the first couple of pages, and it just shows you some basic stuff, how to plug it in. Let's see what else is inside this box. And this is in the box as well. This is quite interesting. This is, unless I'm mistaken, this is to help you remove the keycaps. And these are some alternate keycaps, WASD. And over here we have QWERDF. And these have a almost like a texture of like a tire, to give you a little bit of extra purchase on those most used keys. So I might actually use those, they look quite fun. Let's see what else is here. So opening the box, there is underneath an accessory that I will definitely be using. This isn't very exciting to look at, but my wrists are going to appreciate it. This is the wrist rest, which is optional, and just helps out relieving a little bit of that pressure on the wrist when you're playing or typing for long periods. As you can see, the space bar that does have that same